In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. So welcome to our online service, which we continue to produce on the last Sunday of each month. And we hope that these are proving useful to you in these continuing difficult and uncertain times. Whilst the situation has generally improved and many of the restrictions on our lives have been lifted, we do know that some people remain hesitant about attending church, while others simply cannot. We hope that these services remain of value and of some comfort to you. As we move into the darkening month of November, the Church's mood also seems to darken. In November, the Church keeps the Feast of All Souls, on which we remember those loved ones who have died. Later in the month is the Festival of Remembrance, commemorating the lives of those who died in the wars. Finally, at the end of November, the Church brings its year to an end on the Feast of Christ the King, which comes before the season of Advent. The month begins, however, with the Feast of All Saints. And so as we begin, let us pray. God of holiness, your glory is proclaimed in every age. As we rejoice in the faith of your saints, inspire us to follow their example with boldness and joy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Our first reading is from the Book of the Wisdom of Solomon. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. The second reading is from the Gospel according to John. When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, already there is a stench, because he has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone, and Jesus looked upward and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, he cried out with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go."
Thank you.
so we come to our time of prayer. United in the company of all the faithful and looking for the coming of his kingdom, let us offer our prayers to God, the source of all life and holiness. Merciful Lord, strengthen all Christian people by your Holy Spirit, that we may live as a royal priesthood and a holy nation, to the praise of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless Bully, our bishop, and all ministers of your church, that by faithful proclamation of your word, we may be built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Empower us by the gift of your holy and life-giving Spirit, that we may be transformed into the likeness of Christ, from glory to glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give to the world and its peoples the peace that comes from above, that they may find Christ's way of freedom and life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hold in your embrace all who witness to your love in the service of the poor and needy, all who minister to the sick and dying, and all who bring light to those in darkness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Touch and heal all those whose lives are scarred by sin or disfigured by pain, that, raised from death to life in Christ, their sorrow may be turned to eternal joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remember in your mercy all those gone before us, who have been well-pleasing to you from eternity. Preserve in your faith your servants on earth, guide us to your kingdom, and grant us your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hasten, Lord, the day when many will come from east and west, from north and south, and sit at table in your kingdom. Amen.
Thank you.
be with you. May God give to you and to all those whom you love his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always.